Okay, so awesome news. Remember a long time ago I told you about that Trollstopia coloring book? Well, now we have a cover reveal, but not only a cover reveal, but we also have two new Trollstopia books. I will be putting the links in the description of where you can pre-order or order these books. These books do not come out till January 5th of 2021. Put it on wish lists, or whatever, pre-order, do whatever. And the reason why I say this is because in terms of now, for all we know, because Hasbro and other companies tend to either not say, hey, we have new Trolls merch, or we just don't get that news right away. I do expect Trollstopia merch to definitely happen at some point, just not now, just because it's just way too early. I'm just lucky that I did search on Random House Publishing to see what's going on with their troll books, and they already have the news, so that's good. But in terms of right now, this is like the only Trollstopia merchandise we only know about. So I think we should definitely support it just for more Trollstopia stuff. I definitely think that going forward, I definitely think DreamWorks needs to know that, hey, Trollstopia has an audience, please try to support that. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the coloring book one, because I talked about that a long time ago, and that was like the first bit of troll book news we had a long time ago. But I really like this cover. It's very nice. I definitely like that we're seeing the car that Poppy was riding in with Val in the trailer, and I like the rainbow background that we saw Branch and the new troll delegates just flying around with wings. So yeah, I really like this cover, and it seems to be one of those painting coloring books, not one of the crayon and colored pencil. I'm sure you could probably use it, but it's definitely one of those. I definitely like this cover. There's not a lot I could really say about it, but yeah. Shout out to King Branch, since he made his video about the book news before I did, but I did drop the news, so thank you for the shout out. I'm really happy he made his video first, because he brings up a lot of good questions about these books going forward, and this is why I recommend supporting these books, so in that way we can get more. But King Branch's issue was Branch was not on the covers of these books, and there's something you guys need to kind of remember about Trolls, is Trolls is a very gender neutral franchise when it comes down to its movies and TV shows and specials and things like that. Outside of that, while we do have boy t-shirts, everything else about the franchise is leaning more towards on the feminine side, which isn't a bad thing, because that's what the franchise wants to present itself and be. But at the same time, it would definitely be nice if there was that support for the male characters. But at the same time, you gotta keep in mind, Poppy's the main character. Branch is the second protagonist, but Poppy's kind of the main dealio. So keep that in mind when you think about the franchise. But the reason why Poppy's on these books is because if it was about Branch or Guy Diamond or one of the troll delegates, it'll be a lot harder to sell. One thing I do definitely notice when I'm out merchandise hunting for trolls is if it doesn't have Poppy or Branch or any recognizable characters, they'll probably remain in a clearance aisle, or they'll probably still remain on toy shelves. The snack pack has gotten better thanks to things like Beko's on, so they're no longer on clearances and things like that. Maybe Fuzzbert might, Rip Fuzzbert. But yeah. So the reason why they chose Poppy on these covers is just so that way, it does get more sales. But again, I want to present this. If we buy these books, the more we'll probably see Guy Diamond or Branch or Dante, because me and King Branch love the new character Dante. The more we'll definitely see those type of books and covers. So another reason why I'm recommending highly supporting these books is this is pretty much a direct shout out to the people who are unable to get Hulu and Peacock. This is kind of a direct message to you guys. These covers, they have different names to them, but I can already tell that both of these books are based on episodes. I will say this, they may not have direct moments or jokes in it, but it gives you a good cliff note summary of it. Now, on the Random House Publishing website, there isn't a bio for these books at all. All it just says is, "Hey, new Trollstopia book. Don't forget to support Trollstopia on Hulu and Peacock." And that's about it. But I can already tell you the first book, the one that says A Different Groove, I think that's the title. I'm not looking at the picture right now, but the one with Val on it. I think this one is based on the pilot episode, and I think the one about the gift, I'm not looking at the picture again, but it's on screen right now. I think that one is about the episode where Poppy and Holly go at it with giving each other the best possible gift ever. So if you can't watch Trollstopia, this is the best way you could support Trollstopia. And also get a slight, ever so slight taste of what the episode was like. So it's pretty much a win-win for you guys. You're still supporting Trollstopia and you're still getting a taste of the show. So these books are the best possible win for you guys. Another reason why I say support these books is because Random House has produced troll books that are original stories. Two of them that I own is Branch's Bunker's Birthday. It's an easy reader, cute book. It's one of the tiny golden books. I'm a sucker for those just because of the art style, but it's a really cute book. And then you have Poppy's Pet Problem, which is a book I randomly found at a thrift store. Very cute story and has very nice pictures in it. And I haven't read the Springtime Easy Reader grade. I don't know what grade level it is, but I do have fond memories of reading those as a younger kid. But I will say this, the Trolls fandom kind of needs original troll stories. But another thing also is from the two books I've read, they handle the source material really well. Poppy's Pet Problem, that was a book that was made during the Trolls 2016 era where there wasn't Beat Goes On yet. And I feel like it characterizes Poppy really well. Plus, it introduced a new Trolls character that is not in any other media. Branch's Bunker's Birthday, it feels like a story that happened right after Trolls 1 and Holiday, but also has a vibe of Beat Goes On to it. So they handle the source material well, but I think like it'd be cool to see new original troll stories, but also this could be a gateway for Trolls World Tour character to get books, Trollstopia characters to get books, and heck, maybe even a crossover between the two different things of trolls, and that would be really cool. So yeah, definitely support these books, and yeah, links will be in the description down below, and that's it for this video. What do you guys think about these books? Anyways, I'm Speed Force Spectre, and I'm signing out.